So today we're going to jump right in with the tutorial. We're making Picket the Bow Truckle, Newt Scamander's favorite Fantastic Beast. We're using model magic, some 18 gauge aluminum wire, and these are some wire snips on my needlenose pliers. So first, we're going to start off by shaping a wire base that we're going to build Picket on. So I'm just taking one snip of wire, and then I'm winding another piece that is going to be his arms around it. And then I'm just going to kind of crimp this around and start to shape him. He has three little legs, so I'm going to take another piece of wire and I'm going to actually wind it around that middle piece again, and then that's going to create three legs. So it'll be a piece from the middle and then two legs attached. And then I'm just crimping down with the wire right there. So that is the basic shape that we're going for. Now I'm taking model magic, which if you've seen any of my other tutorials, you know this is one of my favorite craft supplies. It's a really great air drying clay. So I'm basically just taking the model magic and I am going to disperse it over all of the wire. I'm trying to kind of work it to where the wire is in the middle of the model magic, and I'm going to build from here. And this is just a very easy shaping clay. It kind of feels like Play-Doh, so it's super easy to shape in your hands. So just work the clay down along that wire framing. And we'll start to really shape him in the next step. Model magic takes about 48 hours to fully dry. So once you do get him fully shaped, we're gonna let him dry for about 48 hours before we go on to the next step. Technically, it's supposed to dry after 24, but I've noticed that if I don't wait the full 48, it will sometimes crack after 24. And then if I've painted it, then I have to go back and fix all of that. So I just let it sit for a couple of days and then go back to it when I'm ready. So that's our basic shape, and now I'm just going to use my fingers to kind of start making him a little bit more Picket-like. So that is what I have so far, and now I'm going to start making his hands and ears. So I'm taking some wire, and I'm just making a U shape, and then I'm going to wind another piece around the middle to give him like a three-pronged hand. He has very tiny little fingers, so I've seen some people make the hand using kind of like hot glue, just like touching the hot glue and kind of pulling it into a strand. You could do that as well. I just wanted him to have a really strong framing because we were using him in pictures and I didn't want anything to happen to his hand in the event that we were maybe a little rough with him. So that's why I wanted to use the aluminum for the framing. And the way I secured it was I just wrapped the little U around the frame that is inside the arm, and I just kind of crimped it down with my fingers, and it held really well. Now he has a hand, and I'm going to start making his little leaf ears, and basically I just cut kind of like a leaf shape after I smushed the model magic down, and then I kind of put the wire in the middle. That didn't really work, so then I had to kind of reshape it on the wire once it was cut out. And then I'm just going to stick this in the model magic at the top of his head and just kind of find the shape that I like and let it dry that way. So now, same method for the second ear, and we're just gonna kinda twist that one a little bit back. And now to slice the mouth, he has this kind of funny, almost like Muppet expression. So you just use an X-Acto knife to slice it, and then to make the eyes, we just want to make little balls and put them on his face. And now this is after it's dried. You'll see that Model Magic, it does have a tendency to crack, especially if it's older. So I just go in with household spackle and I cover any cracks that I see. This is just basic household spackle. And then I will actually put Mod Podge on it to seal it. So that's what he looks like after he's been spackled. And now I've started to conceal and paint. So I basically put brown on the parts of him that I want to look like he has roots. And now I'm going in and painting over that spackle with green. And I'm going to actually start dry brushing over the brown. If you didn't catch my Elder Wand video, definitely check it out and it will talk to you all about dry brushing. But basically, I'm taking a little bit of paint, wiping off the excess, and then running it over my green so I get kind of like a layered brown and green effect. And you want to do this with a flat paintbrush. So right now I have brown, I have a dark green, and then I have a light green on there. And then I'm going to go over the whole look with this kind of like light candy green, and it's going to just give him a lot of dimension. When I looked at my reference again at the very end, I did notice he is really more of a solid green color. I just think that the dry brushing gives it much more of a realistic look. So that's an up close of how he looks. I'm going over his eye sockets with that candy apple green to really make them pop, and then I'm filling in his mouth with black. This is a 00 brush. So that's what he looks like painted, and now I'm going to go in with the Mod Podge, the shiny gloss Mod Podge, and this not only seals your paint, but it's also going to give him, I think, like just a little extra dimension. Since he's a plant, it kind of brings him to life. It makes him look more plant-like. So I really thought that this was an excellent step. I think I did two coats of Mod Podge, and here is the final look.